everybody, this is Erin at Craft Warehouse, and I'm here today to show you a fun alcohol ink project on this guy. We have lots of metal things in our store that you can put alcohol ink on, and it just dresses it up, makes it beautiful. So today we're doing the butterfly. And because I want them all to be different, because I love color, I am literally making them all different. So here we go. The first color I'm going to start with is Purple Twilight. And these are Ranger alcohol inks. Take a little pad, stick it on there. It's a Velcro surface. And you're gonna drip your ink on it. I'm not afraid to use a lot and sometimes too much. That's just what I do. So I'm gonna start back here and I'm just gonna do a tap tap on it with the pad. It makes a lot of noise on the glass mat, but if you drip on there, it comes right off with a little hand sanitizer or alcohol blending solution. That's all you have to do, is just kind of do it till you're happy with it. It dries really fast. So the next one I'm gonna do, and I think I'm gonna, well, it makes me want to keep going toward it. So I'm going to take my little doohickey here and lay it by that, just in case I want to do some more. Lay it by the Purple Twilight. This one is Amethyst. And I already have a thing on here. Such a wide array of colors. I love that about these. And some are just off slightly from the next color. So it'll be kind of an ombre effect until I get up to the green and orange. Purple is Valerie's favorite color, which is why I use it. See how it's a little different? I love that. Okay, again, I'm going to take off my little doohickey and put it in front of Amethyst. You can wear gloves for this, but I really enjoy having ink all over my hands so I can tell people, look, I did something today. And that's not a joke, that's for real. Like people say, what have you been working on? Alcohol ink. I'm holding it down for your viewing pleasure because it's very loud. If you have not used alcohol inks, you can use them on any non-porous surface. So a tile, anything metal, plastic. I mean, I even have put it around a frame before just because I wanted a little color on it, and it dries so fast that I've just wiped it onto a frame. So this color was Wild Plum that I just did. Again, take off my little doohickey. This way when I go back at the end, if I have some that need a little more color, I'll be ready for it. And this is Fiesta. Came in last fall, I think. Maybe last summer. It's newish. And Fiesta is a really bright pink, which I love for doing anything for little girls. And it's hard to get in there sometimes, so I'm going to take this off. And I'm just going to dab it on there. Yeah, it'll get on my finger. That's okay. I don't care. Because it just means you're being crafty. Okay. So that was Fiesta. Now, I'm going to do Stream, which is a really fun color. It's green and blue sort of together. I like it. So we're going to do it on a big one. And with alcohol ink, there's no right or wrong way. So if you wanted to just smear it on, you can do that. You can drip it on. But for our purposes today, this is just a quick way to do it. But again, no wrong way to do it. Oh, I love stream. Okay, little doohickey off. And I'm going aquamarine. And if you see here, I'm gonna grab my Q-tips. So these are my Q-tips that I just keep just in case, an alcohol blending solution which takes off alcohol ink or thins it out and makes it really fun. So there's a little spot on here on my, what color am I doing? Aquamarine. There's some pink on there that I got on there. Normally it'd be a disaster, right? No, it's not. Drip a little of this on there and rub it on that pink part and wipe it clean. That's right, it's gone. Okay, now back to my aquamarine and my edges aren't working very well, so let's do this. If you've never tried this, come on in and get a pack of our, we have metal tags that you can kind of practice on. If you're not sure you want to do it, just grab a color and color or two and a bag of our metal tags. We have them in a few places in the store. Just ask somebody to help you. Okay, if there's aquamarine. Pantina, nope, patina, sorry. There's no N in it. Patina. That's not staying very well. Patina's fun, it's just really light. We need extra. So who has done alcohol inks? I know there'll be comments on this video, so if you have suggestions or ways that you do it, let us know in the comments. Okay. The way the metal shines, it looks so neat, how it makes some parts darker, some parts lighter. I'm gonna give patina a little bit more love. Okay, put that one down. Next is Valencia.
Yes, I am.
And Valencia orange, that's my favorite color. Why? Because it's no one else's favorite color. No, that's not true. I know one other person, so. Alcohol inks last forever as well. Well, I don't know about forever, but they last a long time. And so I use a lot to get a project done so that I don't have to, you know, work harder. Work smarter, not harder. They don't disappear in one project, so I just use as much as I need because I want it to look the way I want it to look. Oh, okay, I love that. I love it. Okay, so I'm gonna put that one down. And next I'm doing coral. Oops, put a little, get a new little doohickey, some better teeth on there. So coral is the next one. As you can see, these are well loved by all of us at Craft Warehouse. And that's a really pretty color too. Oh, see, I made a little boo-boo there on my orange, so I'll just pick up my little pad and fix it. And I need some edge on here. Some of these are just tucked slightly under other wings, so you kind of have to get your edge. Or use a Q-tip. Okay, so there's coral. And my next one is citrus, which I'm going to do on the big guy. And really, there's no rule as to how much she put on there. I put on a lot. That's just what I do. I don't want to go back 6 times. Oh, and that's really pretty with all the different metal facets. It's kind of faceted or something. Galvanized. Thank you. These are galvanized butterflies, everyone. Just like our hummingbird, which I think we're still waiting for.
Yes.
But we will have the hummingbird soon. We have the leaf in autumn and winter, and we have the snowflake in autumn and winter. Okay, and the last one is sunshine yellow. Okay. So this butterfly is going to be added to a flat, what's it called, like a frame? This guy here. So it's like a flat tray, but it's got the, you know, little doohickeys on the back so that you can hang it up. So I'm adding it to this. And this is one of our vinyls. Color outside the lines, which is perfect for this because when it's finished, it's going to hang like this. So it's literally color outside the lines. Don't you love it? That's right. I love it too. So what I always do with my vinyl, we sell this little squeegee, and before I even peel it open, I go over it once just to make sure it's going to stick fine to the transfer tape. And I just eyeball stuff. That's the kind of crafter I am. I just eyeball things, whatever. Come in and get one of these squeegees. It's they're fantastic. They just are, they're so cute. And then we'll peel it off and we'll do the back and forth like Kara has taught us. I never did back and forth till Kara taught us how, so.
Craft warehouse way.
That's right. This is the craft warehouse way. And boom. Look at that.
How did it go?
So what you're going to do is, I would advise using E6000. It's an amazing glue. I tell everybody to use it. It will stick on here for a lifetime. Anyway, so you find out where you want to put it. Sideways a little bit there, color outside the lines. Oops. Well, once I glue it, it won't do that. And there's your project. Isn't it beautiful? Well, I suggest you try out some alcohol inks. It's so much fun. Talk to us in Paper Crafts, and one of us will help you. Have a great rest of your day.